Meghan Markle has been praised by Michelle Obama for being an inspiration to so many in a heartwarming Instagram post. The shout-out came from the ex-FLOTUS in an Instagram post in recognition of the Duchess' work. Michelle drew attention to the lengths Meghan and Harry have gone to, recognizing the effort and charisma instilled in their charitable endeavors. She said, "Thank you to my friend, Her Royal Highness the Duchess of Sussex as Sussex Royal, a thoughtful leader who is breaking the mold and making our world better for it. Whether meeting with our Obama Foundation leaders or helping girls around the world seek the education they deserve, she is an inspiration to so many." Accompanying the post was a photograph of Meghan with members of a charity in South Africa. The former First Lady is known for her work and advocating for girls' education worldwide. She notably championed the cause in the White House with the Let Girls Learn initiative. Michelle has already collaborated with Meghan, as the Duchess interviewed her for her guest-edited September issue of British Vogue. They discussed motherhood, the advice they'd give their children, and humanitarian work. The pair also met in December 2018 after Michelle attended a talk with Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie to promote her book, Becoming, in London. A source told Bazaar.com that the two were very close. Meghan is currently engaged in a 10-day royal tour of South Africa with Harry and baby Archie. It is their first official tour of the country as a couple, one that will see them visiting several charities and organizations. On Tuesday, the Duke and Duchess started their day at Mwambizi Beach visiting Waves for Change. They then turned their attention to the Lunchbox Fund afterwards, an organization which provides thousands of children with free meals as well as those part of the Waves for Change program. Meghan and Harry finished their day visiting South Africa's oldest mosque, Oro Mosque, where they were pictured eating food and meeting local residents. Later, they held talks with Dr. Thomas Mice at the British Commonwealth. Yesterday, the pair engaged in the most anticipated moment of the tour, meeting WTH Archbishop Desmond Tutu and his wife at their Legacy Foundation. Harry then traveled to Botswana, Angola, and Malawi, while Meghan remained in South Africa visiting the Woodstock Exchange to meet women entrepreneurs and technology investors. Today, in Botswana, Harry will spend time at the Chobe Forests Tree Reserve, planting trees alongside local school children. He will then head to see a project run by Sentebale, a charity he co-founded with Lesotho's Prince Cizia. Finishing up in the country, he will visit Chobe National Park where the prince is due to dedicate a part of the forest to the Queen's Commonwealth canopy. The work continues as Harry makes his way over to Angola, just to the north of Botswana, where he will spend an evening at a New Halo Trust demining camp, following in the footsteps of his mother, Princess Diana, who famously walked through a cleared minefield during a visit to the organization in 1997. As all of this happens, Meghan will stay in Cape Town where she is set to attend a Woman in Public Service breakfast at the High Commission. The royal tour of South Africa will come to an end on October 2nd. Where they will attend the reception in honor of the UK and South Africa's business and investment relationship in anticipation of next year's Africa Investment Summit that will be hosted in the UK.